It's Blaze and welcome back to my channel. Today, as you can see, I'm in a different location, and that is because we are filming day 6 of my 31 days of Halloween, which is DIY. I'm so excited to film this, oh my goodness. I went out yesterday and probably spent a bit too much money, but I got all the supplies needed for this video and a lot of extras, which you will see in a haul coming up. I apologise for Pumpkin's noise, she's been sleeping so nicely all day, but as soon as I set the tripod up, she's like ready to be loud. So yeah, I'm going to jump right into this. I'm going to try not to make this too long of a video, but I'm pretty sure this is the first DIY on my channel, so A, I'm pretty nervous, but B, I'm pretty excited. So please bear with me if the camera angles aren't quite right or I don't explain something properly, because this is my first DIY. Yeah, I have a couple more of these to come, but the rest are more like cooking or baking. My goodness. Yeah, the rest are like cooking or baking, so these are my proper crafty DIYs. So these are all fairly simple. You don't need the most out there kind of tools. I'd say the most like crafty tool in the whole thing is craft knives, and they're optional. So this is all stuff that you can get really easily, stuff that you can just pick up so like for cheap and easily. So yeah, this is a DIY that anyone can participate in. So without further ado, let's get going. Okay, so for the first DIY, I'm so sorry about this camera angle, but so for the first DIY, I'm going to show you how to make these little blood bottles. So I'll zoom in so that you can, I'll show you what we're doing. So sorry about this camera angle. So we've got these little bottles with a little sign on the side. So this one is O negative, and they're full of blood, and you can write whatever you want on them. This one we've got alien blood, and we've only got a small sample. You could write your names on, we've got Jane Doe. So yeah, you could use these little pieces as on the table, at a party, shelving, windowsill, basically you can pop them anywhere, but do be aware of children and pets getting a hold of things like this, just to keep in mind. But this is possibly the easiest DIY of the day, so we're going to start off with these. They're really simple. Yeah, I thought these were like a really cute little gothy decor item to have, and so they'll be perfect for Halloween. Things we're going to need for the first DIY are some little glass bottles. So these are craft bottles, and I picked these up for £1. You can find these in The Works, which is a store in the UK, but I'm sure you could find these on Amazon or just find them online anywhere. The next main thing you're going to need is red food colouring. You could also use fake blood, but I prefer red food colouring. You can find it all year round if you were going to make this at any time of year. So yeah, red food colouring is a really easy option. I picked this up for 79p from Asda. The next things you're going to need are some labels, or you don't have to necessarily use labels. You could just use normal cardboard and cut it into a label shape. Obviously these are far too big to tag these small bottles with. I mean, if you liked that oversized look, you could by all means go with that. However, I'm going to cut these down to a smaller size. Then, if you would like to use the ribbon that already comes on them or the string that's already there, by all means feel free, but I prefer the look of this, I don't even know, jute string, I don't know what that is, but I like the look of that. And then you're going to need a pen to write on your tags. You're going to need some scissors if you're wanting to cut these down. And then if you wanted to make it easier pouring the blood or the red food colouring in, you could always pop it in one of these craft bottles, and I picked these up for £1 again from The Works. So let's get into it. So as you've just seen, I've quickly made these little tags to go on the bottles. So I trimmed them down from the bigger ones into whatever shape I wanted, made a little hole using the pen, and then I've written different things on the tags. You could write whatever you want on these. You could write different blood types, little unknown ones, Jane Doe, vampire, unicorn, alien, basically whatever you want to label your blood bottles as. When I used to have these in my bedroom a couple of years ago, I had the names of all my ex-boyfriends and the people I didn't like, just to be a weirdo. So, this is such an easy DIY. So basically, take a little glass bottle, take your food colouring, fake blood, whatever. Make sure that you use some kind of kitchen paper, because this is so messy and food colouring stains everything. So you just fill it up however much you want. You could fill it halfway, fill them different lengths just to make it look a bit better. Also, just beware that if you do fill it up too high, that it touches the cork, it starts to dye the cork, so it can ruin the look a little bit. So go through and fill up all your bottles to varying measurements. Once those are done, you can move those to one side while you finish off the tags, and all you then need to do is thread enough string through the tags. Make sure you don't get food dye on them, because it's going to ruin the look of the DIY, unless of course you wanted to have them very blood spattered for the effect. I'm going to do some of these with the white string and some of them with the jute string, just to compare, and so there's a bit of variation in there. All you need to do is then tie them onto the bottles, and you can pick and choose obviously which label best suits your look. So there you have it, that is like such an easy DIY, so quick to make, probably 10 minutes maximum, and especially with these tags. If you bought tags that were the right size, it would be even quicker, because you wouldn't have to bother cutting and tying. Or you could literally just use sticky labels and stick them onto the bottle, which would be easier but maybe not look as effective, but it is up to you. So that is our first DIY done. Okay, so for, again, I'm so sorry about this camera angle. For DIY number two, I'm going to be showing you how to make these little mummy candle jars. So they're wrapped in bandage, they've got little googly eyes, and you can pop your tea lights in them. So these are really great on a windowsill, or again, on a shelf, basically anywhere that you're going to be having candles around your home, and bonus points for scented tea lights in these, because that's going to make the environment even spookier. So we've got the big jar here, and then two little baby ones to go along with it. I like things in groups of three, so that's very cute. Okay, so for our mummy jars, we are going to need three jars, and I like to do this with varying sizes so that it looks a bit better when they're all next to each other, but you can use any size jar you want. Then going to need bandages. A lot of you may already have these lying around your house. They're just a normal first aid thing to have on hand. These are my sister's bandages, she gave them to me to use, so I have those. So again, that's something that you don't even need to buy. The jars and the bandages could already be found in your home. You then going to need some googly eyes to stick on. I picked these up for £1 from Poundworld, so I mean, you can find this anywhere. You're then going to need some glue. This is just some glue I picked up from Tiger, which was £1. And then you need some candles to go inside your jar. I picked these up from Poundworld for £1. These are good if you're doing this DIY with children and you don't want to use actual flames, but you could always just use standard tea lights, which again, a lot of people already have around their homes anyway. I'm going to start off with the biggest jar, and all I'm going to do is take my bandage. Oh, pumpkin's crying in the background. I'm going to take my glue, take my bandage, put a blob of glue on the first part, and stick it in place. And then I'm literally just going to wrap it around. It doesn't have to be neat, in fact, it probably looks better if it's not. And you don't want to coat it too thick, or the light from the tea light isn't going to shine through. Then snip off wherever you want to stop, put another blob of glue, and stick it down, and that's one jar done. Thank you. are coated, you can then pick your googly eyes. I'm going to go down in varying sizes just so it looks a bit cuter. So I've got bigger eyes for the bigger jar, and then they go down for the smaller jar. So these should be peel off ones. So my googly eyes aren't peel off, so I am going to have to glue them on, but it's not too much trouble. So once your jars are done, all you'll need to do is add your tea lights. For the last DIY of the day, I'm going to be showing you how to make these little banners. So this one is Trick. This one says Awe, and we've got two little witchy guys, which are kind of hard to see, but there you go, you can kind of see her there. And we have Treat as our last banner. As you saw in the beginning part, obviously you would have it on your wall, but that was just to show you a quick thing there. So this is probably the most tricky DIY of the day, and it's only because of cutting out the banners and writing it on and threading it on the string. I mean, you can always buy pre-made banners in store, but I thought this would be a little bit more fun, a little bit more hands-on, and again, if you're at home with kids and you want something to do with them, some kind of crafting thing for Halloween, then this is a nice easy one. Just make sure obviously you're careful around. I did use a fabric paint which has a lot of smells a lot. I don't know if there's any kind of toxic fumes, obviously nothing's going to kill you, but you know what I mean, so well ventilated area for that, and then also the use of scissors and sharp objects. So yeah, let's get on with this one. Okay, for our last DIY we are going to need pieces of foam or card or whatever you want of your choice to make your banner. So I've got four pieces of orange foam and should have, there it is, four pieces of black foam. So like I said, you can use card, you can use whatever you want. I picked up two packs of 20 for £1 each, but the packs come with loads of different colours, so it's up to you what you want to buy. You're then going to need some kind of filler piece. So the top banner will have Trick, the middle will have Awe, and the bottom will have Treat. So you're going to have a bit of leeway on the Awe tier or layer of the banner. So if you want, you could just have a blank piece of bunting. However, I'm going to use fillers, so I'm going to use these witches. So I got a pack of, got a big pack of witch foam cutouts for £1. So I may try and find something else to do with the rest of them so that I don't waste anything. You're then going to need a piece of foam or card, paper or anything as a template to mark out the shape of your individual bunting. You're then going to need some kind of way to cut it out. You could use a craft knife, you could use scissors, whatever is easiest for you. You're going to need a pen to be able to write on your trick or treat design. You're going to need ribbon to hang it up with. Ideally I wanted black, but I went to Tiger and they didn't have any in stock, and so I decided to use this green ribbon as green for Halloween, so thought that would work. You're also going to need some way to make a hole in your bunting, but I haven't tried this before, so I'm just going to experiment when it comes to that part, so stay tuned for that. I'm going to begin by mapping out the size of the bunting I want on a template using a ruler and a pen. Using my craft knife, you may want to make sure you have some kind of mat in the bottom or the background so that you do not damage your worktops. The only mat I have on hand that I don't want to ruin is My Little Pony, or that I don't mind ruining, so we're gonna go with that. You can begin cutting out your sections for your bunting, and you're going to need 12 sections, so you can do that in any colour order that you desire. Okay, so now I have six of each of my bunting, and now I'm ready to write on the, or draw on the the letters. Okay, so it suddenly dawned on me as I was just about to write out my lettering that a black pen is not going to work on black foam. So obviously, being the intelligent person I am, I planned ahead accordingly. So I suddenly remembered that I had some white Dylon fabric paint that I bought for a DIY that I've not actually done yet. So I'm just going to use that and a paintbrush to paint it on the foam and hope that it works. So if you are better prepared than I am, you could maybe have some lettering already done, or you could maybe use the orange foam on the black and cut out lettering and so on and stick it on. It's going to make it a lot more time consuming and a lot more fiddly, but if you would prefer that look, then go ahead. But I wanted a really minimalistic look, so we are just going to go ahead and go with that. And then I'm just going to go ahead and write or paint my letters on. Going over those black in black felt tip pens just to make sure they stand out as much as the white does. So now I'm going to go back over the white one more time just to make sure that it's fully opaque. Okay, so now I'm going to leave those to dry. I'm going to leave it to dry for about 10-15 minutes and then I'll be back. So I've let them dry as much as I can, but I am running out of time to be able to film, so I'm just going to have to carry on with them almost dry but not quite. So I found that the best method of making a decent enough hole to fit the ribbon through is using a letter opener and to stab it and twist it. So I've done that on all of the orange ones that are already, they're ready to go. So I'm just going to show you on camera how to make a slit big enough to fit the ribbon through. And I'm just doing that in the top corner. Both of the top corners of each piece. I've also done the same for the two witches, my filler pieces. I've popped a hole in the top of each of their heads. So the next thing to do is to measure out the ribbon for how long you want your garland to be. So you need to remember that you're going to have each piece threaded on through the hole twice, so it's going to take up a little bit of room, and you want enough so that there's enough space between them and it hangs nicely. It's always best to do too much ribbon because you can always trim it down later. So I'm going to cut three pieces the same length. What you need to do now is thread your banner onto your ribbon. All threaded on, then that is the final DIY done. Again, I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Again, I'm so sorry about the camera angles and everything like that. This is my first DIY that I filmed, so it was a little bit tricky trying to angle it so that everything looks right. I've just realized it's really dark in here, so sorry about that. Yeah, I hope this video has been useful to you. If you do any of these DIYs, please post it to Instagram or Twitter and tag me below. I am macabre_goddess on both Twitter and Instagram, and I would love to see your recreations. This stuff's fairly simple to do, which is why it's my first DIY video. I didn't want to attempt anything too mental. So the DIYs you've got to look forward to that are coming up next. I have some baking ideas such as cookies and little ghostly spooky treats. I also am doing a witch's hat DIY with my older sister Kerry. I don't know if she'll be in the video, but she'll definitely be there doing it with me. And then I also have a video on how you can turn thrifted figurines into demonic creatures, if you so choose. So those are the DIYs we have coming up. I hope you're excited to see them, as excited as I was to film them. So yeah, let me know down below what you thought of this video, and I'll see you tomorrow for another spooky video. Thanks for watching.